हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम डॉक्टर अनिल पोलपे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स, अरिहंत कॉलेज ऑफ आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस, बावधन, पुणे। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डिमांड एनालिसिस। फर्स्ट इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ डिमांड एनालिसिस। डिमांड एनालिसिस इज वन एरिया ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स दैट has been used most extensively in business. The whole range of planning by the firm, manpower utilization, production planning, investment decisions, inventory management, profit planning, etc., call for a detailed analysis of demand. The market mechanism depends on the forces of demand and supply. It means demand and supply analysis it depends on the price mechanism. Then demand analysis is important in two ways. First is that it provides a framework for analyzing price and other influences on the sales of the firm production, and second one is that it provides a baseline for pricing products and marketing generally, and for forecasting and manipulating demand. Then Professor Alfred Marshall compares price determination in bracket through market mechanism to cutting a paper with a pair of scissors. It means the two blades are demand and supply. Just as the process of the cutting with a pair of scissors involves the function of both blades. Similarly, the function of price determination involves the working of demand and supply together. Either of the two by itself cannot determine price. Then, demand analysis is concerned with the economic activities of consumer, that is consumption. The process through which a consumer obtains the goods and services he wants to consume is called demand. Then what is demand? Demand means effective desire or want for a commodity which is backed up by the ability and willingness to pay for it. Demand schedule and demand curve. Demand schedule is a table which shows the various amounts of a product which consumers are willing and able to purchase at each specific price in a set of possible prices during some specified period of time. There are two kinds of demand schedules. First is that individual demand schedule, and second one is that market demand schedule. First, individual demand schedule. It means what is the individual demand schedule? The demand of an individual customer for a commodity is called the individual demand. The following table shows that the demand schedule for a consumer. This table are divided in two part. First part is price of apples in bracket rupees per kg, and another side is quantity of demand in kg. First, at that time 12 rupees per kg price apple, at that time the quantity of demand is 1 kg. This is the apple of price and quantity of demand, which is two variables are inversely related to each and other. Then this is the demand curve. This demand curve draw with the help of particular data given below of backslide, and this particular demand curve is negative slope, and also it is seen the above diagram that when the price of apples is 12 rupees per kg, only 1 kg for apples are demanded. When the prices comes down to the 7 rupees per kg, the consumer buy 6 kg for it. Hence we seen an inverse relationship between the price and quantity of demand. Then next one, second another part is that market demand scheduled. In the market there are a large number of consumers. Market demand means the demand of all the consumers in the market for a good at a particular price. Market demand schedule shows the total demand of all the consumers in the market at various prices. It can be constructed by the summation of the individual demand schedules of all individuals in the market. This table shows that market demand schedules for apples. Then next, determinants of demand. There are many factors on which the demand for a commodity depends. These are known as determinants of demand. First determinant of demand is that price of the commodity. Second one is that consumers' taste, preferences and fashions. Then third one, consumers' expectations about the future price and supply position. Then advertisement of the product. Then next point is that climate and weather conditions. Then level and distribution of income and wealth. Then next point is that change in savings. Also next point is that state of business. Then technical progress, and last government policy, which are the all points are depends upon the determinants of demand. It means there are factors are affected in the determinants of the demand. Then another next point is that law of demand. Law of demand means the law of demand is one of the best known and the most important laws of economic theory. This law simply expresses the relationship between the quantity of a commodity and demanded and its price. Professor Samuelson says that regarding about law of demand. Law of demand states that people will buy more at lower prices and buy less at higher prices. But condition is that if other things remaining the same. This is the important line of an important condition of the particular law of demand rules. Then assumptions of the law of demand. There are main four assumptions are there, and this particular assumptions has under the law of demand. First assumption is that no change in taste, also preferences of consumers. Then second assumption is that consumers income remains the same. Then the prices of related goods do not change. And fourth assumption is that wealth of the consumers or their taste remain constant, which are the four assumptions of law of the demand. Okay, this diagram is demand curve. It means this diagram shows that the inverse relationship between commodity price and quantity of commodities. This diagram shows that price is measured along the y-axis and quantity is measured along the x-axis. The demand curve is downward sloping, which is in accordance with the law of demand. Thank you. Thanks for watching my video. Thanks once again.